Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath, back from New Zealand. Thanks for checking out my video again. I just completed a video on secretory IgA antibody. Now I'm going to talk about what the IgA antibody in general is. So this is a blood-based antibody. So the way to assess it is through the blood, through the serum. Same way to assess IgM, IgG, and IgE, other antibodies. So IgM is an antibody that is made by the immune system, predominantly found in the lymph, to counter any viral or bacterial infections. IgG is a marker that is hugely abundant in the body. It's found in all the tissues everywhere, all the fluids. And this one is first level of defense produced also for bacterial and viral infections. IgA, however, works on the mucosal surfaces. So this antibody, like the secretory one, is particularly important for ear, nose, or throat, vaginal, bladder, urinary tract, you know, all those mucosal surfaces. So in my opinion, if you want to assess what the digestive IgA levels are like, which I've spoken about in the previous video on secretory IgA, you need to do the fecal test. However, you can do a saliva one if you want to determine, in my opinion, other levels of the secretory IgA, you know, for the mouth and things like that, you know, oral and bladder health and stuff like that. But the serum is also important. It's, in my opinion, important to do the blood test for the IgA as well as a saliva test. Or you can also, if you've done a fecal IgA, you can also do a blood IgA and have a look at both levels to see what they're like. And sometimes there'll be patterns where they'll both be low or both be elevated. So it's quite interesting for you to do that if you wanted to complete that. So the blood one is very important. Also remember for vaginal health, bladder health, and those other things, whereas the secretory, the gut, okay? So yeah, this might be a useful video for you to define the difference between the serum-based one and the secretory IgA. Thanks for tuning in.